You know, when the world sees images of America, they think, yeah, they've got a lot of food, but they don't think that hunger is a serious problem for our children. And it is, and Chef Bruno Serato knows that. 7 nights a week, he is making sure they don't go to bed hungry. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in honoring CNN hero Bruno Serato.
My name is Bruno Serato. My passion, besides food, is feeding the poor children in America. I started a foundation in April 18, 2005. I was making awareness of motel kids who live in Anaheim in the motel area. And they told me he could not have dinner that night because it's a residence, it's in a motel. No kitchen. Mom cannot even cook for him because there's no kitchen in the motel room. And mom was with me the day from Europe, and she said, Bruno, why don't you feed him a pasta to this little kid? Yeah, look at mom, and he clicked. I was like, yeah, you know what? We should feed him a pasta. That was the first kid, April 18, 2005. Right now, we're like to do 1,000 children every single day that we serve free pasta.
Are you ready? Let's go serve the pasta to the children. Viva la pasta!
When I have one-on-one interaction with the kids, it's the most amazing moment in my life. I get hugged, I get high five, I get kissed. They're like, oh, your spaghetti with tomato sauce are the best one ever. And when you hear that from children, that is what I want. That's the best review.
And if I were to rate this pasta, I'd rate it a 10.
How's the pasta?
It's not all about just a plate of pasta that's in front of them. It's about having the security and the comfort of having a dinner.
We're always thrilled about helping Bruno and the kids. I mean, how can you not help kids who are hungry and want to eat? And this year, it'll be 1,000 kids that Bruno feeds every single night.
What a motel kid is, it's a child of a family who lives in a motel, who literally live in a motel. Whether the family's down on its luck, lost jobs, or what have you, they don't have any stable living situation. So what they're forced to do is live month to month, paycheck to paycheck, by living in a motel.
It was 2009 when all those layoffs, I lost my job. I was laid off. It took me a good 2.5 years, even with a good resume, to find another position. So we ended up in a hotel.
So when we went to that motel, we were in a room with just a 2-bed. They had like bed bugs. People would come there to party, I guess. Couples screaming and yelling, and my kids would be like, what's that noise? Why are they yelling like that? They can't go outside, they can't play out there because who knows who's in the other rooms. It was just not good.
When we were younger, my mom separated from my father, and then it was just us for a while, going motel to motel. I was at the point where I'm starting to want to think about college and think about a future, and like all I'm seeing is how hard it is, how you have to struggle, and how, you know, to stay in a house and stuff. Sorry. That's so. It was just like hard to think about how I'm gonna get ahead in life.
Motel rooms, a lot of time you find prostitution, drug addict, drug dealer. And some family was lost job and work and stuck in this room. And it's kind of sad because the kids is with a very bad environment. The sooner they move, the sooner it's safety for the kids.
Living paycheck to paycheck, you can't save enough money for a down payment. You can't save enough money for the first and last month's rent. You're stuck going month to month. And that's the cycle that happens with these families that are stuck in motels. So what we're trying to do is give them the opportunity to get out of that cycle.
I start to do charity. I start to pay first and last month to qualify family. To qualify, you need to have 2 kids minimum, have a job for 6 months. Because if you have a job for 6 months, that means you want to be back on track. And if you do that, I pay first, last month, you moved to a 2-bedroom apartment. is a huge impact for family.
This is our new home, and we wouldn't be in here if it wasn't for Chef Bruno. So when we first got here, the kids were all excited about the stairs. So now we have it's a townhouse. Yeah, it's really nice. On top of everything else he's already done for us, he gave us a living room set, and he gave us a dining room set. It was really, really nice. They all have a bed now. They don't sleep on the floor anymore. Bruno came through for us and helped us get into an apartment. Now we're settled, because that's what my problem was, getting into the apartment. And he did that for us, and now we're on our feet.
Bruno came up to me, pulled me aside, and he said, you know, I heard you were staying in a hotel. You know, how long have you been there? Like, why didn't you say nothing to me? You know, this is what I do. Like, you work for me. You're, you know, I know you. You're like family. Like, I would want to help you. And so he did, and I'm in an apartment now, and it gives you so much hope, and I feel so thankful.
But I believe then, if we all put hand in hand together, we can save so many kids, which they are in need of.